What's up, guys? Sean Fowler here at Level 1 Game Room. Also follow at Twitch, Level 1 Game Room as well. Sean Fowler, part of the Jessica Network. I'm giving my top 5 welterweights in the boxing, today. Number 5, again, I'm Sean Fowler. I'm saying Sean Porter. Sean Porter is, for me, number 5 because it's always going to be a brawling type of fight. He's always going to get into it. He reminds me of a mini Mike Tyson. He's a brawler. He gets into you. He really attacks from the inside. He's had some big losses, like to Keith Thurman. We've seen recently back last year against Errol Spence. It went down to the final round. It was a split decision, I believe, or a majority decision. But Sean Porter, he gets my respect. He's number 5. Number 4, I'm saying the guy that's on top ranked side under Bob Arum, Terrence Crawford. Now, some people might say that are real boxing fans, how could you have Terrence Crawford number 4? He should be number 2, number 1. You know what? I haven't seen him really fight anybody other than Amir Khan. I think he might have fought possibly some other notable name, but he hasn't fought the top guys in the PBC side, like a Sean Porter, a Manny Pacquiao, and he was actually with Tom Brink at the time. He hasn't fought a Keith Thurman or Errol Spence. So for me, I know that Crawford's still undefeated, but he's number 4. Number 3, I have one time. He only lost one time, but his nickname is One Time, and he's one of my favorite boxers, Keith Thurman. Now, I got number 3 because, you know, that fight against Manny Pacquiao, it was close. It could have went either way if he didn't get knocked down, but he got knocked down. It's a flash KO. He got right back up against Manny Pacquiao in the first round, and he landed some good shots. Manny Pacquiao came prepared, though. He took him. He didn't go down one time like One Time did, Keith Thurman. And I think overall, Keith Thurman is one of the better boxers in the welterweight division, but because he has that one loss, sorry, Floyd did to you guys. But you can't necessarily be, you have to continue to be undefeated to be number 1 or 2 for my list. So he's number 3 for me. Number 2, the truth, Errol Spence Jr. He's still undefeated. He's had some tough bouts against Keith Brook. We've seen how that was a couple years ago. He went up in weight and he defeated him. We've seen what he did against Mikey Garcia last year, dominated him for all 12 rounds. And we've seen his recent bout against Sean Porter. It was a tough and rugged fight, like most Sean Porter fights is, like I described earlier. But in the 11th round, what did he do? He knocked him down, caught him with that left hook on his chin, and he still remains undefeated. Hopefully he continues to recover up from that crash that he had months ago. But until then, I'm saying Errol Spence Jr. is number 2. And number 1, the People's Champ. I got to give my friend Jansen some credit here because it's Manny Pacquiao. And Manny Pacquiao, for me, overall, is my second favorite boxer of all time behind Floyd Mayweather. But what makes Pacquiao special is he just keeps coming. He's over 40 years old, and to me, he's still the best overall welterweight boxer in today's sport. He still has the speed, the power. He definitely surprised me in the Keith Thurman fight. I had Thurman winning. I'm shouting out Jansen again because it was a couple years ago when we reconnected. I said Lucas Matisse would beat Manny Pacquiao. I thought Pacquiao was done. I thought he was washed. But no, he said, Sean, no, you're tripping. I'm going to go win the fight, and I'm going to still be the United States champion. Excuse me. So Manny Pacquiao is my number 1 fighter in the welterweight class today. Again, please like, follow, subscribe to us on YouTube, Instagram, also Twitter, and also Facebook. Comment as well. Have a blessed day.